Hey guys, Janik here for Cinecom.net and welcome back to Copycat Friday. And today will be a very special tutorial because it's going to be our first 3D tutorial. And better yet, it's going to be my first 3D experience. So in other words, I'm learning together with you. Now the fake 3D hologram effect is actually two tutorials. We need to make the hood from the glasses, but this is the exact same principle as the Iron Man hood. And we already made this, so I'm going to skip this step and go right to making the floating 3D object. If you want to know more on how to create these hoods, I'll leave a link to the Iron Man tutorial in the description below. And who knows, maybe there will be a bonus for those who watch until the end. Wink wink. Now what do we need for the effect? Of course we need a 3D model. We found ours for free on TurboSquid. Then you need some footage. Now because it's our first 3D tutorial, we're going to make it ourselves easy and shoot from a tripod. Then the last thing you'll need are glasses. Because otherwise we lied in our title. We have these cool movement glasses, which are perfect for this effect. Now besides being stylish and looking good, the ever-scroll glasses also have a very important role here at the office. We are constantly working with digital screens and sometimes for very long hours. This of course can be very harsh on your eyes. Science told us that blue light waves keep our brain awake, and overexposure to these light waves can cause some health issues like eye strain or headaches. And that's where movement comes in. With their ever-scroll glasses, they protect our eyes from the blue light waves. Now, skeptic as we are, we put that to the test. Jill wore the glasses for over a month to see what effect it would have. And guys, Jill approves! You can compare the movement glasses to the eye comfort stand on your smartphone. The only difference is that the glasses won't turn your screen yellow like the smartphone setting. In fact, the glasses won't alter the colors in any way, so they are perfect for color grading. If you want some cool movement glasses for your own, go to the first link in the description below and save 15% using that link. Now that we have our shot, it's time for the post-production. Open up Blender. We are going to use the free TurboSquid model, but you can use whatever you want. The first step is to animate our object. Select your box and go to the property toolbar on the right. Here you can select the object properties. On the very right of this tab, you see little dots. With these dots, you can set keyframes. We are going to click on the Z location and the Z rotation. Then in the timeline on the bottom, enable the auto keyframing. Just check this little box. Now if we go 25 frames further in time and move our box up, you can see that Blender automatically makes keyframes. Now to make it ourselves easy, again go 25 frames further in time, select our first keyframes, copy them and paste them where our playhead is at. Now repeat the copy and pasting of the previous keyframes until the end of the timeline. Then for the rotation you can simply rotate it a bunch until it's okay for you. Now look at that, we already have a moving box. Next up is placing the box on the right spot. Select your camera in the collection tab and go to the camera property. Here enable the background image option and add the image you want. Now if we look through the active camera, we can see the background image. Again go to the object properties while your camera is still selected. And with the location and rotation, you can now position your object in the right spot. We're going fast, guys! Next up is the lighting, and for this we are going to use an HDRI image. In plain words, it's a 360 image of your environment. Now, how do we add this to our object? Open your shading tab and the first thing you can do is change the shader data from object to world. Then add a node with pressing Shift A. This will give you a drop-down menu. Go to the texture option and choose the environment texture. This will create a new node. Now take the color dot and drag that to the background color dot. Click on open and select your image. Now because our HDRI isn't on the right spot, we need to rotate it. So let's add two more nodes to fix that. Press Shift A, go to vector and choose mapping. Again press Shift A, go to input and choose texture coordinate. Now link the generated dot with the input vector dot of the mapping node and the output vector dot with the vector node of the environment texture. Damn, 3D is complicated. But with these nodes, you can now easily rotate your HDRI so your lighting will match the scene. And that's it! You can always change the material settings of your box, but that is something personal. Now the last step is rendering, because we need to get it from Blender to After Effects. Go to the render properties and under the film tab you can enable the transparent option. Next, go to the output properties. There you can set the file format to MPEG video. Under the encoding tab, you can set the container to QuickTime and the video codec to PNG. After that, you can enable the RGBA option, which allows you to render with an alpha layer. And last but not least, change the location you want to render to. This way you can easily find everything later on. Once you have set that, let's render it all out. Go to the render tab on top and choose render animation and that's it. Now load your shot in After Effects and let's start with creating the hologram effect. Place the shot in your comp and the first thing you can do is create the shadow of the box. So duplicate the background and with the Lumetri effect we are going to make that duplicate darker. If we now create a mask in the same shape as the box and animate the opacity, we already have this cool floating box. Now let's add the glowing circle. And we are starting with the highlight on the floor. Make a blue solid and place it underneath the box. First, let's create a mask in the shape that you want your glow. Then look for the Vegas effect and drag that to the solid. In the effect control panel, you can now adjust the settings. First, max out the segments, then set the blending mode to stencil, adjust the color to blue and the width to around 20. Normally, you would now have a blue circle on the floor. Also add the directional blur to the solid and set the blur length to around 10. After that, duplicate the solid above everything and delete the two effects. In the effect library, you can now look for the CC light burst effect and drag that to the duplicate solid layer. Adjust the center of the effect and place it underneath the circle. This will make the light rays go upward. Now increase the intensity to around 190 and that's it. If you want, you can always use a corner pin effect to make the glow straight up. Again, a personal choice. Last but not least, set the blending modes of the two solid layers to add for a better blending. Then decrease the opacity of the box to around 60%, add a simple white glow effect, and if you want, a Venetian blind effect for the hologram look. And that's it! You now have this super cool fake 3D floating hologram box. Now for the people who are still watching, I have a reward for you guys! If you go to the description below, you can find a link to download our own HUD completely free. How easy is that? And let's all thank Lorenzo for making that HUD. Send your love in the comments below. Now, before I say goodbye, it's time for Janik's Fun Fact Fountain! Well, it's not really a fun fact. More like an announcement. Did you know that we are doing daily stories on YouTube? Every Cinecom member has his own segment. Jill recommends movies on Monday, Lorenzo shows off his socks on Tuesday, I spread my fun facts on Wednesday, and Jordi is being silly with tips on Thursday. There are four reasons to don't miss out on all that daily awesomeness. And that was it guys! I hope you liked our first 3D tutorial. Let us know in the comments below if you want more tutorials like this. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you Movement for the support. And like always, stay creative.
Blue light fashion. Everybody wants those movement glasses. Because they give protection. Protection against the blue light. Light is blue, light is bad. But we have movement glasses.